A triple whammy. That's how Nelly Colmenares, lawyer for Transport Group Estron, described the Transport Department's jeepney modernization program. Colmenares warns jeepney fares could jump by up to 40 pesos as jeepney operators and drivers pass on the cost of new models to passengers. The new jeepneys cost around 2.6 million pesos. Colmenares also shares they are still hoping that the Supreme Court will issue a status quo ante order to reverse the DOTR's December 31 consolidation deadline for jeepney operators and drivers.
Many of them are not really against modernization per se.
Okay.
What they're against is this concept of modernization, which will cost 2.6 million pesos. Is there any way wherein it is affordable to the drivers and the operators rather than this? Because the moment it's like 2.6 million pesos, it will impact on the drivers who cannot afford to pay. And secondly, it will impact on the commuters who will be paying a higher fare rates.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the thing there.
Catholic devotees are starting to flock to Quiapo Church ahead of the Feast of the Black Nazarene. The Quiapo Church also gearing up for the blessing of the Black Nazarene's replica, which will begin today. Organizers know the Black Nazarene will be encased in a glass during the grand procession to protect it from being damaged.
Naman siya talagang malaking pagbabago, kundi pagpapanumbalik. Saan, all throughout ng prosesyon, sa ibabaw ng andas, makikita ng lahat ang imahen ng itim na Nazareno. Dahil mapapansin po natin yan, yung mga previous years, minsan ho mas marami ang tao, kaya natatakpan na po yung imahen ng Nazareno.
President Marcos wants the Philippines removed from the gray list of a global anti-money laundering watchdog. Remittances of Filipinos abroad could take a hit if the Philippines fails to resolve the issues flagged by the watchdog. Katrina Domingo reports.
The Philippines needs to exit the gray list of the Financial Action Task Force, or FATF, within 2024. That's the order of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. a year after the lapse of the FATF's deadline for the Philippines to address issues related to the entry and exit of illegal funds into the country.
The deadline given by FATF was January 2023. It was last year already. And it was not extended. However, since we already did not meet the deadline of January 2023, we're still in the gray list. And our aim, the aim of the government, is to exit the gray list this January 2024. That was a self-imposed deadline. But we are still hopeful that we will exit the gray list this year, 2024.
The FATF is an international organization tasked to issue guidelines and recommendations to stem several monetary issues, including money laundering and terror financing in the world. In June 2021, the Philippines was placed on the FATF's gray list after the agency found that the country lacked several safety nets against money laundering and terror financing. While the Philippines has already addressed 10 of the 18 issues earlier flagged by FATF, the country's Anti-Money Laundering Council, or AMLAC, says 8 more problems have yet to be resolved. Among these issues, the lack of registered casinos and jewelry stores, more liberal access to information on the ownership of businesses, and more stringent investigation and prosecution of those involved in money laundering schemes. If the Philippines fails to address these issues, the country is at risk of being blacklisted alongside the likes of North Korea, Iran, and Myanmar. If that happens, Filipinos sending money from abroad will be among those hardest hit by the FATF's sanctions.
Yung OFW natin, maapektuhan mga transaksyon nila. It's either higher cost, more requirements, documentary requirements, and sometimes de-risking or their transactions will be disapproved. Yan po ang repercussions ng blacklisting.
The Philippines' credit rating is also at risk.
Basically, there's already a reputational risk on the Philippines, particularly on the economy. It might also affect foreign direct investments in the Philippines, because if you don't exit the gray list, they might think that our AML-CTF system is not adequate enough or sufficient enough or strong enough as regards money laundering and terrorism financing.
The International Monetary Fund earlier said that the Philippines' push to exit the FATF's gray list has been improving. But the IMF also notes the country needs to do more to avoid serious repercussions. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
Let's get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Anna Clauden. Anna?
Good morning, Bettina. The northeast monsoon is now prevailing over the whole Luzon, bringing cloudy skies with rains over Cagayan Valley, Apayao, Aurora, and Quezon. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon, we're expecting a partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated light rains also due to the northeast monsoon or the Amihan. While the easterlies is now affecting the rest of the country, but these easterlies will bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over the Zamboanga Peninsula, Northern Mindanao, Caraga, and Davao region. The rest of Mindanao and Visayas will have partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. Currently, we're not monitoring any weather disturbance or low pressure area that may affect the country in the next 3 to 5 days. That's the latest from PAGASA. This is Anna Clauden Horda. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna. Heading now to Japan for the aftermath of the powerful New Year's Day quake. The death toll now at 57 as rescuers race against time to search for survivors. But aftershocks and freezing temperatures are complicating rescue efforts. The full extent of the damage remains unknown. Satellite images show parts of Japanese coastal cities reduced to rubble. In Suzhou, a town of just over 5,000 households, 90% of houses are believed to have been destroyed. Filipinos in Japan recall their traumatic New Year celebration following Monday's strong tremor. Thousands of Filipinos are residing in Japan's quake-hit areas, but all of them have been accounted for. They are still appealing for help, though, amid a lack of food and water supply.
Yung kunting alog lang po, parang nakasanayan na namin dito simula nung dumating kami rito sa Japan. That time kasi talaga, sobrang inisway talaga kami nung ano.
Saka kung tumagal po kasi talaga siya. Then 3 minutes ang tinagal. Mm-hmm. Yung building na katabi namin na nagsasway din talaga. So talagang gumagalaw po talaga lahat. Pati yung mga drawers na wala namang gulong, talagang aabante siyang pag-anon.
Philippine authorities, meanwhile, gave assurance it is closely coordinating with the Japanese government for assistance. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. also vowed assistance to Tokyo as it deals with the quake's aftermath.
So, meron na rin pong inulat kahapon si Prime Minister Kishida na in touch na daw po siya sa mga self-defense forces units na ipapadala po sa area that have been affected. Additional units from the police and the fire departments have been deployed and nagpapadala na po sila ng supplies by air and by sea to the areas that have been affected.
Japan is facing its second tragedy in as many days. On Tuesday, a Japan Airlines plane burst into flames at Tokyo's Haneda Airport after a runway collision with a Coast Guard aircraft helping with quake relief efforts. It took more than 6 hours before the fire was extinguished. All 379 people on board the Japan Airlines plane escaped, with 17 of them injured. But 5 of the 6 crew members in the Coast Guard aircraft were killed. Communications between the control tower and planes in the fatal crash are being investigated. Japan's transport minister says the cause of the incident remains unclear.